Should be back up.
Video preview.
Okay,
it's up.
Let's get started.
Okay. And yeah, it's not using. Okay. Hopefully everything is better now. Sorry about that, folks. If this works better, it just means I should probably give my computer a fresh boot after video editing. Huh. If I'm gonna stream. Still saying please insert game disk. There it goes. Perfectly normal Twitch.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. Greetings, and welcome back. You're doing a good job. First, a recap of your previous visit. I'm sorry to inform you that a death has occurred in the laboratory. The cause of death was starvation.
Oh, shit.
I should hope that this will not happen again in the future.
We starved one of them to death.
So let us head over to the tank.
Listening?
Hello. Hello?
Well, hello.
How are you today?
Yes.
How are you today?
What do you want?
Talk to me, Seaman.
It's cold in here. Yeah, that's good. Oh, goody. Oh, goody. Yay! Yay!
What are some things we can use? Tell me a story. Tell me a story, Seaman.
You certainly are.
Get tickled for that. And drink gin.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it.
Talk to me, Seaman. Oh,
knock it off.
Talk to me. Talk.
Try going a little
Seaman.
Bit farther from the, mic.
Yes. I'm hungry.
Too bad.
We've got one food. I guess give it the one food. We may have to do an emergency make another save game, transfer food between VMUs. Oh, yeah, it's a really weird interface. So, like, what you do is you grab with that. Oh, wait. Grab by pinching. Okay. Flip it out. Let go. They're sort of trying to keep this, like, hand metaphor thing going. But it actually makes the controls
good.
Kind of
food.
Awkward.
Oh, yeah, his name is Fido.
Oh, yeah. Fido!
That was terribly delicious.
Fido!
No, I'm fine.
Hi, Fido.
No, not really.
That's not how English works.
No, not today. Maybe tomorrow.
Maybe we should come up with tickles.
Quit it. Quit it. It hurts. Quit it. Quit it. It hurts.
Are you happy?
What do you want?
Are you happy?
What?
Was that a yes about Pikachu again? Are you a Pokemon? I didn't understand what I said.
What's up?
Are you a Pokemon? Pikachu!
I'm fine.
It's completely misinterpreting everything I say to it now. Find out you can look above the tank also. Recently. Look at that water. So realistic. It's really small when you actually look at it compared to the tank. Or the tank is really big. Any suggestions? There's a separate document on GameFAQs, it's just the words.
I don't know if I really trust this.
Why would it?
Oh, it's just full of garbage. Like, I don't think this is actually... I don't think any of these things are actual.
Okay, yeah, some of those do not seem likely.
No, no, in fact, most of them seem extremely unlikely. Yeah, no, this is I do not trust this document.
What do you eat?
Like,
what
we're supposed
do you
to be
eat?
Trying to trigger, like, the questions.
Yeah.
I don't know.
What are the next...
What's
what are the next
up?
Questions it's supposed to ask?
It asks incredibly invasive questions about your personal life.
Okay.
It's a good time.
How are we doing? This image doesn't register at all. What's on your head?
Many things.
What do you want to be when you grow up? Didn't like that.
Yes.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
What's up?
How is life?
Thanks.
PlayStation.
That name sounds familiar.
Nintendo. Nintendo.
There's definitely stuff that comes after this. Nintendo. I recognized it, but I didn't want to say anything about it. Seems to be in a good mood.
Yeah, I don't know.
We can just go to the next day.
Sure, let's see how.
Wow, now that's dark.
You can actually still kind of see it a bit.
Yep.
Can you turn the light on? Oh, my eyes, my eyes, my eyes.
Yeah, I'm just gonna give it one more little wiggle.
What? Oh, knock it off. What? Oh, knock it off.
Okay, let me see if there's anything else we can think of to say to it.
Yeah, let's just restart.
Okay.
Would you like to save and end the session?
Okay, we'll give it one more day, but I think after that we need to cheat.
Yeah, we need to load up another game, fill up the VMU with more food pellets so it doesn't starve to death.
I figure we can do that for next time.
Yeah.
Hello. Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset. There is a definite pattern to your visits. It appears you are a punctual person. At the moment, the habitat contains 1. Gilman. He is suffering from the cold. Please use the heater to raise the temperature to a more comfortable level. So let us head over to the tank.
I'm cold. Oh, sweet.
So apparently we may have needed 2 Gilman to get us the next.
I'm frozen.
We may have lost it.
It's really cold in here. It's really cold in here. I'm freezing.
I don't know if the next step is the fog or not.
I thought the next step was Seaman.
Yay!
I think we're on that step.
No, this is Gilman.
Is this still a Gilman?
Yay! Took you long enough.
So I do know that it gives you more eggs.
Hey, you.
Yes? How are you, Seaman?
My stomach is growling.
Oops.
That is so far never.
Oh. Stop it. I'm gonna pee if you don't stop.
Talk to me, Seaman. talk to me. He's ignoring me. Talk to me.
Fido. Fido.
They only recognize it when I say Fido, given its only speech recognition.
Speak English.
What do you want?
Speak English. Talk to me. Hello.
Yes?
Speak English.
Sweet as sugar, baby.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Questions? Talk to me. Speak. Speak. Hungry?
Yes, please.
Well, can't help you with that.
I think I need some food.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna have to cheat in between this week and next week, I think, to give him food. And I'll also check to see whether we may have gotten ourselves irreparably stuck.
I think it gives you a new egg, though, so I think...
Okay. Oh man, then does Seaman eat those eggs and then they burst out of him?
That sounds like this game. I hate it.
That sounds like the type of thing that they would do.
I hate it.
Because there's no Nautilus to feed them to.
That's true. Oh, why is this game like this?
Because it hates us.
I'm thinking about some food, eh?
Eventually, it lets you, it gives you a bug cage that you can grow food in, but we haven't gotten that yet, and we're far away from getting that. So, yeah, we're just gonna have to cheat our way. Which is cool, we know how to do that, we think.
Yeah, we've got multiple VMUs, and you can transfer food between VMUs.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start a new save file on a new VMU. Transfer the food from that VMU onto this save.
Which actually do, the VMUs can plug into each other and have like little screens on them. They're pretty amazing.
Anyway,
just Google Seaman how to get more food. Okay.
Would you like to save and end the session?
I'd load up another day, but I think we might kill him if we do that.
Yeah, he might die.
Okay, so we're just going to set up the next game, which will be SOS. Almost, give me one sec.
Okay.
HDMI.
The chat says no more dying in the boiler room, but I think we all know we're gonna die in the boiler room.
That's my plan.
We're gonna do our best to definitely die in the boiler room.
Oh, I am plugged in. We're trying to fix things. That's why it's not.
I can neither confirm nor deny that we are time wizards.
Yeah, let's see if I can get this close enough to the screen for people to see. That's the VMU. So it has like a little app you can run that has your Seaman food in it. And then you can plug two VMUs together and transfer. The Chao game that was in that horrible Sonic, had all sorts of stuff you could do. You could like make Chao between VMU and make them fight and stuff. Okay. Looks like we're good.
Let us know if the audio is balanced right for this.
Yeah. I never noticed it said it was like a such and such film.
Yeah.
That's cute.
Okay, we want to be,
the audio seems to be one garbage track on repeat, needs fixing.
Unfortunately, we cannot help with that problem.
Yeah. Communication. Communication. Play bridge. Am I in control yet? No. To find sailors. Yeah, we're doing the same potion to see if we can actually manage it.
At this point, our victory condition is, can we survive?
Can we save one crewman?
Ourself.
Or one seaman?
Miguel, no. We can immediately dash to the boiler room, but it won't actually be open until 30 minutes in. Unless we, like, fall multiple times, in which case it'll be open very quickly.
Which totally will not happen. I am not known for jumping
long distances
and falling and dying. How to talk to people. You hit X. Man, I sure do miss unskippable cutscenes. Oh, okay.
I really like the communication prompt.
I think I may have just been going through communication with him again and again as I was trying to button mash through that.
Communication? You're just waiting for the...
Yeah. I'll talk to these people.
Ship to capsize.
Communication? There is a storm outside. It is dangerous. Come back to the cabin. Is the ship really in trouble?
No. we're gonna die. Okay, don't wander too far away.
Yeah, no. Bombed directly? We must hurry up. Whoa! I went back to that gorge when that happened. Okay, do we know where we want to head me?
Yeah, just give me a second.
Here's the map. I will turn it upside down.
Cool, sweet.
Oh, hey, how
are you showing up on it? Yeah, that actually is where you are. That's really weird.
I wonder if there's a bug with this emulator and this, even though it's supposed to be the best.
I mean, this is like super accurate emulation, like to a fault. There might be a bug in the game.
Yeah.
Okay, so give me a second.
Yeah, this is so weird knowing where I am.
Should I pull up the... Yeah, you want to go... go right.
Go right?
Yeah.
Which button is the wrong button? Okay, there we go.
Keep going. Next one.
Jumping on corpses! Can't.
Oh, well that's cool. Okay. You're gonna want to be in the room on the right.
So I need to go up of floor and around. I wonder if now I can make it. Communication? Yeah, now
you
I can make it.
Okay,
I'll go through here?
Yeah, go down.
Shit!
Okay.
Oh, wow.
Excellent.
I thought that was the
one of those doors.
Any of them?
Yeah.
Okay. It's looking good. There's a red emergency light.
Now go right. Up.
Okay. Gotta love that jumping.
You really don't. Okay, go right.
What is going on? Is there a thing in
the other right.
Oh, okay. Sorry. That was very confusing looking.
Hey, remember this room?
Oh, yeah.
Let's try to go about this differently.
How about I die? I'm good at that in this room.
Aw, oh, man.
Just gonna do some practice jumps. Okay, so there is some air steering in this game. It's not pure Prince of Persia. It's just this very, very little air steer. That's pulling back, and that's pushing forward.
I can definitely confirm that Lady Killer is both on a boat and also there's water in it. Whether there's Seaman and Lady Killer, I don't want to spoil anything. However, that'll be filthy.
Yes!
Whoa!
Fuck.
Okay, that was not great.
But we're really early in the game, so it's okay.
Yeah, it doesn't matter, because the boiler room won't open until 30 minutes in.
Wait for it to finish whatever it's doing.
Doesn't look like it's
Can you hear, though? I can hear
I can hear it, but it's not vibrating, so.
Yeah, but
oh,
now
there it is.
See, yeah, it gives you a warning. First the sound, then the vibrating. Sometimes I played it without sound, so I didn't even realize that was something you could do.
Well, that didn't really actually.
Okay. Oh, fuck! These controls are so good. They're just so good.
They're real good controls.
They're the best controls. I love them. I want to marry them. They're just so beautiful. Basically, I can die like two more times without it. Okay. Oh, fuck. Now it's going to start tilting again.
Hopefully, it tilts in the direction I want.
Oh, it does fake rumbles too. Oh.
We did it!
Oh!
And then...
Yeah.
Still,
it's
good.
Still practice jumping, which
I exactly.
Need. Okay.
Up.
Up here? Okay. Love that jumping.
Oh, it's real good. Keep going up.
This bit with the flute sounds like RPG. Then this way?
Right.
Yeah. Right meaning correct?
I didn't. Your other correct.
Okay, my other correct. Got it.
Okay, now up left.
Okay, yeah, how do I do that? Oh yeah, I can wait.
You're gonna hold on.
Get the defibrillator ready. A defibrillator. Oh!
Well, cool, great, awesome. Awesome. Good game.
So good at this game.
Actually, I really like that fake out. That's good.
Yeah, no. Oh. Door.
Okay, so how do we get up there without it flooding?
I think this is where I may need to wait for the flood.
Oh no,
I can see.
A shot.
May as well, like.
Yeah.
Oh. I've got no idea what's going on with these stairs. Through here? I think so.
I'm actually not sure. I don't see.
That's, I think, where I go when it floods. Oh shit.
Okay, yeah, that's correct.
I'm just gonna stay here where it's safe no matter where it tilts and drink some gin.
That there's no jumping in late killer. That would be extremely dangerous.
Okay, which way do I go here? I can never remember.
Up, right.
Up first, I'm guessing?
Yeah.
I don't like that you jump lower than you can actually, like, your normal jump is too low to actually grab onto something. But then, oh, whoa! But then it, like, pops you up a few pixels if you're in the right spot.
It's really, really weird. Give me a second to remember where this is.
This is where we might need to wait if I need to get to the higher parts. Let me see if it shows us in the map. Nope. Whenever the bug is, it makes us
stop. Oh, but we're also in a back area right now, so my...
Yeah. Oh, it's shaking. Oh, yay.
You remember this?
Yes, I do. Up, jump, fall off, up, jump, fall off, up, jump. If anyone's new to the stream, yes, I have to do this. It moves me some sub-pixel over so that the jump works and I don't hit my head.
Remember, the top door. Yeah.
Yeah. If I hit door activate before I jump, I fall through the door by opening it below me. The prettiest part of the game. Okay, we actually don't know what the hell we do here. Right?
Okay, so remember, you're gonna be going to the end of this platform, falling, and then going slightly to the, and then going
to
the left.
I need to try, like, crawling off.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
And then go...
Oh, fuck.
Well, we almost had it.
The... Please spawn me down there.
Hey, we've got like 7 chances here.
Don't say numbers.
Okay, yeah, grab that floating thing.
The one here, okay. Okay, there's like random steam now. Does that steam kill me, do we know?
Yes. Okay, now just slightly to the... Is that thing you can...
Jump back?
Or...
Yeah, it looks like I jump back.
Yep.
That seems to be the only option. Okay, and then
now
jump.
Now you can climb onto that.
Yeah. Okay.
So remember, those hooks are for climbing on top of.
Yeah. So I jump here, and then do I just do a blind jump? I think
yes.
That's what I did.
Yeah, it's that thing on the left. Yep.
Yeah.
Cool, great, awesome. Love it.
Oh yeah, they fall. That's where we died one time. Oh, fucking fuckity fuck.
Almost there.
Yep, feeling the seething rage that only SOS can cause.
Come on, you almost got it. You're... Home stretch.
Ooh, also the game is now running at like 10 FPS.
But the audio's playing fine. This is just that's a visual effect that they thought would be cool. Okay, so you're gonna grab onto the edge of that.
Yeah, I think I need to actually do it from the end there.
No, keep going right.
Climb up.
Oh my god! You can do it!
Is that a...
Go! Door!
That's a...
Door! That thing.
Oh, yeah! Couldn't recognize it because of the weird lighting. And I was... Oh my god!
Who's we?
Fuck no. They were all creepy fish men. And they were rude to me.
Wow. Wow. We just got shamed for not rescuing anyone.
I am sort of the winner. Humbleton.
recap boiler room with, like, people in tow.
Oh, Jesus. So yeah, we've basically beat the equivalent of easy mode.
Yep, we got a bad ending. Cool. He's the easiest character to play as.
I've got to say, I'm happy we actually managed to finish this within the four streams.
Yeah, we actually...
I did not think that would happen after last time. But apparently I've gotten better at the shitty jumps each time.
Yeah, so, like, you can see how, you know, like, getting used to how the ship turning helped us out a lot. Like, knowing that it always, like, turns to the left in that room...
Yeah.
Means that we could have spent, like, a good 15 minutes rescuing survivors.
Yeah. No, definitely, like, learning what those things are. Just learning, like, the general route. Like, I was still a little bit...
No,
like,
it's only four playthroughs.
Yeah. See, I could see over time getting to the point where you could be beating this. If I was, like, a kid who bought this when it was a new game.
And it's the only game
you
have. I could
see slowly getting better and better at it.
And your parents are screaming at you because there's only two songs in the game. There's credit music. I'm really glad that they have a second song.
Oh, hey.
Yeah, it's not.
Sweet sound of victory.
And you probably wouldn't actually know playing the game because why would you, like, leave the volume on?
Actually, now I know you really would because those sound cues for when it's going to tone are really useful. And
yeah.
I didn't even notice that at first.
Yeah, the other thing is that you can only rescue 6 people. Like, more won't follow you. So, really, there's... Instead of 2,400 people dying, it will be 2,394 people. Great. Awesome.
I wonder what the point is at which old games started using real credits. Because I remember, like, beating a few early Japanese games. It must have been, like, Master System games or something where they'd all be, like, using pseudonyms. So there must have been at some point where that stopped being a thing.
Three songs.
Main music, slightly different song for the boiler room. What if there's a vocal version of this? Yes, but all of the lyrics are just SOS.
So in the Japanese version of the credits, it features like the characters and has like fake actors for them. So there's like a slightly modified version of Gene Hackman's name for the character that is obviously Gene Hackman.
Oh.
But they took them out for legal.
Finn, no pun intended.
Why would you read that? Why would you acknowledge that, please?
How do we ban people from chat?
Okay, I'm gonna fire up something.
Okay.
Do you want to explain?
Okay, so for those who haven't seen BS Zelda before, it's a game for the Satellaview, which is basically a sort of radio modem type device attached to a Super Nintendo. And there would be downloadable games that would be transferred over the radio, but it would actually be, like, at a certain time. So it's like, I'm going to play this game at 7 p.m. on, like, Saturday, because that is when they're showing BS Zelda.
Yeah.
So, like, the first 7 minutes would be it downloading the game data over the satellite radio from this station, St. Gigas, that Nintendo co-owned and... was involved
They had, like, a licensing agreement. Because they weren't doing very well, because their whole thing was that they would play, they didn't have a schedule. They just played ambient music that, like, sort of slowly shifted genres over the course of a day. For some reason, they were in financial trouble by the time Satellaview came out. I can't imagine why.
So, what BS Zelda is, it's a game for that is a remix of the original Zelda with newer art. And it's episodic. So on the fourth episode, each episode is a section of the map, a little bit more of the map opens up each time. You have a set amount of things to do, but the whole thing is also kind of narrated live in real time. So there's an hour to beat the episode, and during that hour they've got a set of songs and they've got a set of events that happen.
As well as like a sort of broadcasting narration.
Yeah, and a lot of hints, partially because they had to make sure that everyone would finish it within that hour, because when the hour finished, you couldn't replay it. You just have to wait until the next episode you could try to catch up.
And also all the narration, like, it's tied into in-game events, but it's specifically, like, it's always the same no matter what, because it's just a radio broadcast.
So they have no idea where you are.
Exactly.
So they have to sort of have events that either are like world events or like spells that just affect whatever place you happen to be in. Do you need me to crank it here, or did you just crank
that
it?
That should be okay. Let us know if it's still quiet. So yeah, the only data that was transferred was like the actual game itself. The audio is all just live broadcast if you were listening.
So yeah.
Somewhere, descended from heavens, there lies golden power.
I've never actually listened to it.
The wishes of those it shines upon.
I'm actually kind of curious.
To the gods.
The one other thing is that this is
these
a fan dub.
These passed down in the land of Hyrule.
This never existed in North America.
Obviously not.
And your wishes.
But also the whole thing is just reconstructed based off some people saved the game on the cartridges, but also the audio is all reconstructed from VCR recordings. So people tape playing the game, and that's how we know what happened.
Those captivated by the legends sought the sacred realm for themselves. However, of all people, the first to open the gate to the sacred realm and obtain the Triforce was Ganondorf, leader of the
Thieves.
Okay,
let's get
through this. It was at
this
moment.
Okay, I'm kind of curious.
Oh, we've
never actually played it.
All right.
Ganon was born. Before long, Ganon's malice spread over Hyrule, and sinister events began to occur. One after another. The King of Hyrule therefore commanded the Seven Sages and the Knights of Hyrule to seal away the source of the malice. The people of Hyrule, by divine revelation, had created the Master Sword, a sacred blade.
Oh, so this is what you'd be listening to while
that may steal the Triforce.
While it's downloading.
However, even the
that reminds me of the install for Interstate 76, one of the best games ever, had radio broadcasts that basically set the scene.
People waited for a hero with the power to wield the sacred Master Sword to appear. But the force of Ganon's malice didn't wait for the hero's coming, and pressed closer to the royal palace where
a
grand
lot of them
battle
saved. Like, there are a lot that we only have one of, and that's all that exists. And, like, no recording them at all, we just know that because the log file is out there. The only reason why Zelda is so documented is because they reran it a lot of times.
Yeah, I can imagine it being one of the most popular.
After tremendous sacrifice, the sages at last succeeded with the seal. And as the curtains fell on the conflict known as the Sealing War, peace visited the land of Hyrule once more.
So I guess that was all the original Zelda story.
The dub was done by, it's fans on a forum somewhere. I don't remember the name offhand, but, if you search for, Zelda dub.
My name is Princess Zelda. I have been imprisoned in a dungeon by an evil power. Rise quickly, hero. Hyrule. Hyrule is in danger.
Avatar.
A puzzling message shatters the moment's peace. Hurry, hero. Return peace to the land of Hyrule once
more. Yeah, we're not gonna do that. That's not gonna happen.
It is funny how much this story is like the old Ultimas, and that like you are sort of not playing as Link, you're playing as yourself transported to that world.
Yeah. Oh, that's the other thing. So the avatar we're going to be playing as is, as you can see, it's not Link. It's the character from the Satellaview BIOS. So you could, like, create your character and name it, and there is a boy character and a girl character. So that's why we're a cute red-haired girl.
Could you choose different hair colors and stuff?
No, okay. You could only choose boy or girl sprite.
So it's a very early version of me.
Extremely early.
Oh, wow.
Oh, darkness has fallen over the land.
Yeah.
Welcome back once again, hero.
We were in a dungeon when that happened.
1 week has passed since this land was covered in the black mist of the evil king. Monsters once contained in the dungeons rampage on the world above. However, I have just gathered enough strength to tame them. The dark clouds will clear soon. Now, the battle to regain the Triforce begins again. Two new dungeon entrances have appeared since last time.
Oh, we're gonna have a bad time.
The remaining Triforce pieces must be in these two mazes. Once you have gathered the 8 pieces, the Triforce will be complete. Now go. I shall try to help fight your enemies from here tonight. You do not have much time left to remain on this land. Let's hurry. After I restore the world above, I shall look into manipulating the minds of the merchants. So, hero, take this sword.
You must find 2 dungeons.
Oh, God.
Then you must retrieve 2 Triforce pieces. But the old man said nothing about where the dungeon entrances are. The old man will return the above ground to its original appearance and has convinced the merchants to begin discounts.
Okay, that's good. At least stuff's discounted.
That's great. Oh my god, this are you shitting me?
Hello again, hero. I shall use my power on the world above now. Itala.
Oh, we're back to normal.
The old man's power has burst out. The dark clouds have gone, and the monsters of the dungeons have turned back into the original monsters from above ground.
I think that might be the better...
Go, hero. Now, my spell appears to have broken the armors. If you provoke this enemy, it will come to life. Wait, what is it I see under the foot of Armos? Is it? Oh, the power bracelet. It has been lost for hundreds of years. This was used by an ancient hero. You should
take
it.
Will Karina take us to the last dungeon we were in?
You can find Armos stones to the north of Hyrule. These are what has awakened. See what happens when you touch them. Some Armos are standing before the entrance to the northern Rocky Mountain. Making the Armos walk away should let the bracelet appear. The power bracelet will allow you to move heavy rocks. For example, you can move large rocks blocking stairs.
Oh, because it's not safe.
The level 7 dungeon lies ahead of that. Under a stone, there is also a secret passage leading to remote locations. Do your best to unearth this.
Oh! Those guys are now... So one of them will have the power bracelet?
I don't know about that. Why is it starting with 3 life? I hate this.
Life is pain.
I've given everything. I've given everything I've got on this one. The minds of the merchants are being manipulated.
We need...
A discount sale has begun. Do you have enough rupees?
I don't
Use your time wisely.
Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah. Items you okay. Need.
A shield to protect yourself. A ring. Meat to proceed within the level 6 maze. And medicines to recover life. To buy medicine, you need to find
the
cave
of
the old woman.
Yeah, it's got different colors.
The cave
does
where
it?
The old
yeah.
Woman lives is located near the flying flowers. The pea hats. You'll need a letter and a bomb.
Yeah.
The letter is given to you by the old man near the eastern
gates. A red cross
lakes.
On yellow, isn't it? Oh no, it isn't. Okay.
The secrets of the dungeons. Level 1 dungeon. The entrance of this can be found without difficulty. It contains the bow. If you can find the right block to push,
nope,
be sure to obtain it. Level 2 dungeon. Its location is the giant rock next to the northeast cliff. You can't find this entrance without breaking the rock with a bomb. If you kill all the Goria using boomerangs, you can obtain one for yourself. Also, if you look at the labyrinth map, you can see where there are rooms separated from others. To get to where you need to go, break the walls with bombs.
Oh, right.
Level 3 dungeon. This place is south of the forest. Obtain the raft here. There is a secret in the room where you see the key in this labyrinth. Think about where to go from that room in the south, where you can see the key, but can't obtain it.
How do we do this?
There must be bombs in a nearby room. It is also possible to take it with a boomerang. Bombs are necessary for going beyond to the old man's room in the labyrinth. Level 4 dungeon. This place is by the lake north of the forest. It's possible to get past the pier if you have the raft. The flute can be obtained here. There is a block that can't be moved until all the enemies are defeated. If you spot it, the flute will surely be obtained. The Triforce room is located near the entrance, but you need to find it from the back room, so don't rush. The level 5 dungeon is at the sea to the east. Locate and go past the pier with a raft. Find the tomb surrounded by armor statues. Walk towards the cliff behind the tomb. The cliff is but an illusion of the evil king. Give the old man that is hungry in the labyrinth the meat. Obtain the ladder here. Level 6 dungeon. The entrance is at the sandy beach in the southeast. Use the flute to reveal it. Find the magical rod in this labyrinth. There is a wall you can pass through without a bomb. Walk toward that wall.
Chat, please remember the hints that we were given, because we're terrible at that. So we've got that problem we're gonna have those guys you have to feed bombs to.
Seems to have recovered somehow. For a while, I've been watching the circumstances of the dungeons, and I'll tell you, those bubbles, they're regrettable. They are the most annoying things to fight.
True.
Let's seal off their power for a little while.
Okay.
Now.
The old man's spell has turned all the red bubbles blue. Now you can go through the dungeons without being pestered by bubbles.
Level
7 dungeon yet? Awaken the armor statues and be sure to take the power bracelet that's hidden beneath one of them. Then push the rocks blocking the stairs, and the entrance is to the east of this rocky path. Does the white sword shine in your hand? Meet the old man at the graveyard if you do not have it. Reach the cemetery, exit the forest from the west, and go north from the desert. Then push the gravestone in the middle. If you have enough life, you should get the powerful white sword.
Oh, we got the thing, and then we're going through here. Oh, yeah.
The genie and the graveyard have a secret. You can't defeat the genie who appear when you touch tombstones. They are mere illusions. The genie who was there from the start when you enter is real. All the illusions are sure to disappear if the real one is defeated. It's easy to tell the real one in a crowd. The real one doesn't fly diagonally.
Oh!
Okay, that was bullshit. That was bullshit, and I hate it.
Have an uphill battle. I shall try to help with the lightning spell. Mmm, yutah!
Stop!
Yes!
Oh, you need to kill all of them, huh?
There's back in the original area.
Yeah.
There's a woman who sells potions.
So what are you supposed to do with these statues?
I don't know if these are the ones.
Unfortunately, all the merchants have regained their senses.
What?
Everything is back to its original price.
Fuck off, fairy. Got it. Yeah, I bet, like, you start at the same spot every time. We'd probably just go grab a potion every time before we go any farther. I imagine when people were originally playing this, there's a lot of people, like, sharing hints between episodes.
Is the fight
badly?
I shall try using the lightning spell again. You too.
Man, those torches really felt that.
Oh, it waited until there were enemies.
Oh, that's nice.
That's, yeah. Okay, so it's not completely cruel. Completely useful either, but you know. That's not giving anything.
Seven dungeon, you may get your hands on the red candle. This is different from the blue candle, in that it can be used multiple times on the same screen. There are stairs that you may not ascend because of blocks preventing passage. Try to think of a way to enter from the north side of that room.
A statue in the forest found a red ring.
Oh, thank
you
God.
Should get it by any
oh,
means.
That was the boss.
Yeah.
When you obtain the red ring, your protection will be even greater than when you have the blue ring.
Wait.
Hurry to the statues in the forest.
What was the dungeon? We don't
statues
have
statues in the forest.
What was the boss that.
No, it was a boss, it was a something, I think it was... he'd already gotten the thing.
I wonder if you know about the magical sword.
Okay, how do we...
It is a stronger sword than the white sword. The old man at the base of the Rocky Mountains found the magical sword. You should get it by any means.
Oh.
If you use a sword even stronger than the white sword, there will be nothing that you cannot achieve. Hurry to the foot of the Rocky Mountain.
Oh, I think I know where it is. This way.
Hero. The evil king is after the magic sword and red ring. You will not be able to obtain them if the evil king finds them. That would be terrible.
No shit.
You must get to them first. You need to hurry. The red ring is beneath one of the statues near the Lost Woods.
That's
the
totally
magical sword is upstream of the river, in the cave beside the fountain. You need the ladder to get it. You have 10 minutes left to get these.
Try up here. Go up the right hand. I don't know why we need the ladder, they're gonna get wrong.
Okay.
Yeah, well, cool, great. Okay, so now we need to go down to the Lost Forest.
Yeah. Have you found the level 8 dungeon?
Fuck no.
Get off my dick.
I believe
it
is already in sight. Head north to the Rocky Mountain.
That's... we just saved a lot of time.
Push the rocks to go up the stairs to there. Up the stairs to the east is the level 7 dungeon. Moreover, towards the west on the other side are two large rocks called Spectacle Rock.
Oh, where the fuck are
we? If you use your bombs here, it will surely reveal the level 8
dungeon.
Oh,
we don't have the power thing yet. Right. Yeah, I think we're start going towards one of the other dungeons.
My computer's running slow. We're gonna have to get some, we're gonna have to cool it down.
You need a fan
on it, yeah.
Okay.
We're just pausing for a second because my computer's overheating.
Just plug it in on the other side there.
Sorry, it turns out it's very hot here.
Have it already popped up a bit?
No.
Yeah, you can just throw this VMU under it.
Yeah, let's just let that run for a minute.
Okay, so we need to loop back around.
Yeah. By the way, this would be totally impossible in the actual version of this. Like, you can't pause because it's a live broadcast.
Yeah.
So we... mind you, our Super Nintendo would not overheat.
This is also true.
Yeah. So... okay,
oh, we didn't get a warning, we just noticed it started slowing down.
Yeah, it was pretty choppy. Oh, are Armos the thing that, like, the armor statues?
I think so. keeps talking about things being under them, and they didn't activate before, and now they do.
Yeah, yeah.
I kind of like the way that the world, like, just slightly evolves each time.
Yeah, no, that's really good. And, like, I do really like, you know, it starts up and the world has fallen under darkness.
I'm surprised they didn't just keep it like that. I wonder if there are technical reasons.
I mean, it might kick in, like, after this. Like, it might kick in, like, the next 10 minutes.
I'm half tempted to say we should have just tried doing a continuous stream of these and do all four in one go in an afternoon.
Now that we actually know.
We also wouldn't have the we forgot what we were doing problem.
So, yeah. So part of this is, like, this is meant to be played if you've played Zelda 1 before, and I have not played Zelda 1 before. This is all new to me.
And I'm similar. I was a Master System kid, so I only saw Zelda being played by my friends.
My friends who are much more loved.
So do you think it's probably better now?
Yeah, let's give it a shot. How's that sounding?
Yeah, it's good now.
Fortunately, we've got helpful advice. Okay, so where are we going now?
Try going south just to see if we can find another shortcut. Oh, interesting. Go in here. Can we set fire to the big trees? I forget. And I'll talk.
Fine. Nope, we're not going back to level 5. Fuck that shit.
The level 8 dungeon has the Book of Magic and the Silver Arrows. The Book of Magic enables your magical rod to work as a fireball.
Yeah.
The spell cast from the rod tears up enemies, then becomes a flame and blazes up. You can light darkened rooms with a fire rod. The only thing known about the Silver Arrows is that they are more powerful than ordinary arrows.
Yep, there it is.
There we go.
Woo!
Oh yeah, powerlifting. Boom! I have no idea what's going on.
Yeah, but we're not gonna get the red ring if we head this way. It's too late, we'll find out now.
The red bubbles are back to full power. You need to be careful. If you touch one, you won't be able to use your sword until you touch a blue bubble.
Yes!
Nice!
Medicine! Which one is?
Guessing 68 is better. Oh, we've already got that one. So wait, did we have medicine before and not realize it? Like, does that
I thought it was a... I thought it was an empty bottle.
Is there a reason you're killing all of them? Just to get stuff. Like, there's only ever one exit, right? Yeah.
Okay, well, this
is
a lovely
dungeon.
Where's the red ring?
Red ring, red ring.
Some of the other,
yeah, I wonder if there are other shortcuts.
Like, you found one with the ladder. You would have had the ladder sooner.
Oh, okay.
Oh, you can go across that now.
Yeah, that's a good shot. Unless we can get that
far. Yeah, so that's the whole sort of open world-y type thing, where there's a lot of more stuff that we can get at. As the weeks go on. Hard.
I saw the evil king heading for the red ring and magical sword. Both must have been taken by now.
What?
Let's now use the spell of whispering again.
Are you shitting me?
Use it to find your hidden allies.
No! No! Oh my god!
No,
this
may
is
have
a spell
checked.
That the old
no.
man has used once before. There are various things
nope.
hidden under
nope.
trees
oh.
and walls. You should hear a strange noise when you come to some locations. Something you have not found yet is concealed.
Oh, neat. So now...
Use your candle and bombs to reveal it.
What are we doing?
What are we doing?
Wait, what did he just say?
Use your... If you hear a sound, it means it was something you haven't found in that area yet.
Like that.
Yeah, I'm guessing like that. And, use your candle to reveal things.
Except I don't have a multi-use candle because
yeah.
we are so far behind. God, that was brutal. Alright, let's... Okay, so what's
our... I can't
believe
we were waiting for text to appear.
Oh, that was so bad. That was just cool. Like, there's no fair way to do that because of the way it works. Like, it has to be time-based. It's just cruel.
Oh, we have the ocarina. Go down and play it at the beach down there.
This one?
Yeah. Oh, no, one over. I think it's here. We haven't found the secret. half.
Oh.
And yeah, there's an ocarina there now. I listened.
Oh, level 6, okay. Yeah, sure, we can totally do this. This is no problem.
Use the torch. I like the way the ladder is just like a portable single.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, to sing at it.
Right.
And then it breaks up into a shuffle.
This is how I have those. Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck them up. Oh.
It's fine. I can't believe that was a mini boss. I can't believe it grows old bosses like this.
Grand rabbis.
Yeah, but also like lights. Really, really can all with my sword.
There's something about...
Oh, yeah. There's a secret. We just walk through the...
If we don't hustle.
Oh.
Oh, push one of
yeah.
The blocks. There was a thing with a key underneath this. I don't know what this is. Oh.
Rejoice, hero. The power of the stars that guide you now flows in my body. This power is magnificent. Up to this point, I have used all of my abilities for you. But, one at a time, using this power, you can decide the outcome of your battles in a single blow.
Now is our chance. You can use all of these abilities at once with this. You can throw your sword even without full power. Moreover, bombs and arrows are infinite, and you can use the magical boomerang. Let's try to challenge the remaining dungeons with this opportunity.
Get the key. You might need it for another dungeon. Is this just a resource in this cell lot? So just one south of the snake room. I think they may keep that for the rest of it now. Yeah, no, that's neat. So there's the...
Yeah.
Your efforts are for naught.
Whoa, who's that? That voice just now. The evil king? Where is he? Where can he be? This is strange. I swear I heard something. Beware, hero. A sign of the evil king. I feel an incredibly powerful evil force. I do not think my own power can compare to his. It is possible he may appear at any moment.
A sign of the evil king. The time has come for him to show up at last. Where is he? Where will he appear?
Oh god damn it. Use your potion.
I hit that, yeah.
Anyone know how we beat this?
Oh, arrow. Arrow to the eye.
Okay.
This one arrow. Awesome. Yes!
Catching up.
Okay. We just have two more to go in 10 minutes. Cool.
We know where one of those is.
We are so incredibly fun.
Yeah. Go up here, there's a extra heart we can get.
Let's get
that. I don't know. Back down, we can just use the if we go down and lift that rock, is that shortcut we took?
Yeah.
We can get back to the next dungeon for us to do.
Except we still need to find 7.
Oh, except there.
Do we know where 7 is? Doesn't matter. Ganon's gonna show up.
Oh. Okay, this will take the bone here somewhere. But...
You despicable fiend! I see. You think you can win if you quickly seal my power? I won't let you have your way. The power of the stars flows in my body now. You will not be able to seal my power so easily. What are you doing? Let go. Let go. Hero. The silver arrows. The silver arrows.
Something serious has happened to the old man. Ganon has settled inside the old man's cave of all places. Be sure you have all 8 Triforce pieces. Without them, you will not be able to face Ganon.
So that's cool. We know where he is. Which is awesome. We're so
thing we heard from the old man was him crying for the silver arrows. The silver arrows are in the level 8 dungeon. if you have them, as well as the 8 Triforce pieces, hurry to the old man's cave.
We don't have any of those things. We have, in fact, none of those things. This is so bad. Where's level 7?
Dungeon already, but you've found the silver arrows. Try letting yourself be captured by a wall master. There must be a room where a different colored wall master appears.
beside you that I want to see. Oh, we can pick all of these up now. Oh, there's some sort of secret here. Try getting the point of the arrow. Part of the music.
Yeah, they might have done a black guy cleanup on them. Yep. So remember, this music is recovered from tapes of the playing, so. This is really not helpful.
Not that, that's just a dude. That's not the answer. Oh, by the key.
We have 4 minutes.
Yeah.
I remember there was a hint about this area, but I cannot remember what it was.
It's not there.
There's obviously something went by there, but I don't know what it is.
But the rule is only one cave per area, right?
Still,
yeah, it is part of the song. The secret sound is part of the song.
I think it's a bad cleanup.
No, it's in time with the music.
That's terrible that I hate it.
Okay, so we do know where the thing is. We should have no idea how to get there.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe we do it up and around?
Okay, we'll try. I know there's a hint that told us how to do it.
Yeah. Problem is, you're usually trying to solve the current puzzle.
Yeah, because we're so far behind.
Yeah, we're still missing
the
ring, but we can't get it. We're too late. Again, because this actually has real-time stuff in it. You can just be too late to get certain items. This gets...
Second last one, yeah. gonna do it.
Oh.
Yeah, 7's probably.
The Triforce is mine. Hyrule is mine. Everything. It's all mine! The hero has failed. Hyrule is lost. Now no one can stand before the evil king.
So that must have been recorded so that they could...
I bet what they're doing now is that, is now they're playing the alternate version and muting the audio. So right now it's probably telling us that you have triumphed over Ganon.
Yeah.
But they just muted the broadcast audio.
And then play this instead.
Yeah.
Interesting.
That must be how they're doing it.
Yeah.
That's the only way you could possibly make it responsive. Which, so, like, it's good for, like, a special occasion, but it doesn't...
Yeah. Yeah, you couldn't do that normally because that would be way too much data
yeah.
at the time. Especially.
Well, I mean, it would just
minutes.
Be wasting time is
yeah.
the thing.
Well, a valiant effort.
Yeah.
Should I switch us over? Oh, it's doing the credits, which are unfortunately over at the side, so we've got a different setup for... maybe I'll switch it back while the credits are running. We can reminisce on our failure. Definitely made up time. Yeah, no, it definitely, like, you can see how they do little things within the rhythm of the game to help people catch up if they're behind.
Yeah. Oh, and this is the cast of the dub. And, yeah. So these are the people who...
made it happen.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, it's interesting the sort of way it's designed to try to help us catch up. Like, we fucked up too much, but...
Yeah, but we could've.
Yeah, we weren't, like...
Like, definitely at the end, it gives you, like, a lot of...
Yeah. The fact that you're basically like, here, have, like, God mode.
I can't believe he fucking beat us to the Red Ring by, like, 12 seconds. Not even. Like, we were, like, 2 seconds away.
Yeah, no, it was literally in... Like, I feel like at that point it should've... Like, I would have made the other choice and be, like, a little bit nicer, so that if you were mid-thing...
It's hard to
get. You have a chance. That theme is
That's
great.
It for...
Switch us over. So, yeah. I wish we'd managed to do it, but...
Ah, oh, so close.
It is definitely, like... If you didn't have hints, like, you'd have a similar sort of gap in forgetting stuff if we'd been playing it at the actual time. Like, the broadcasts weren't one day after the other. They were, like, a week
was,
away
yeah,
or a month away.
A
The other BS Zelda is friendlier on letting people catch up.
Yeah, so this was the first one that they did. And, then
and probably a lot of people ended up like us.
Probably. Although probably, you know, also people who had actually played Zelda before probably did pretty well in this. Like, it's definitely very forgiving if you actually know how to play.
Yeah. I feel like they must have actually gone out of their way to program the Red Ring disappearing.
It doesn't interrupt the text, so I think it just removes it from that. I don't think that was deliberately made.
Yeah, I think,
I think otherwise it would cut off the text.
I think we hit an edge case that they never thought anyone would have.
Or that,
or
like,
just,
that might be the intent.
Yeah.
It would be pretty difficult to, like, change the text just because of the way it works.
Yeah, no, I could see basically they, like, finish text, then if the ring is there, swap it over. And suddenly the ring was not there. You wouldn't need... Oh.
Yeah,
okay.
So in the length of the past one, you wouldn't need to catch up on dungeons.
There's ancient stone tablets in that one. You wouldn't need to clear the dungeon from the previous week. Rather, you get the tablet from it, but would be missing stuff. You need to remove the sprite based on the... Okay. Two different conversations. One about the ring.
Yeah, it's
one
possible
about
that might actually be a programmed in edge case then. I mean, I assume once the ring is stolen, you just can't get into the room. That's probably how.
Yeah, I don't know.
Although,
like, it was... I could see
maybe it changes the... It might also just remove it from the room and change the string, but the string has already been loaded into memory.
Yeah, it was already in the middle of doing that
yeah.
string, but not in the middle. Like, they're separate events in how they coded it.
Yeah, there's a number of ways that could have gone down, I think.
And, of course, the whole thing
either
is
way,
coded in
it's
assembly.
A whole fucking
so.
Dick move.
So we haven't actually figured out what we're streaming next week.
Yeah, we've got some ideas. We'll figure it out.
Yeah, do we want to tell people what things we're thinking of and seeing if they can suggest games, or...
Sure.
So there was a few different ideas. One was weird Sega games to keep the Seaman thing on point. Another one was games about, like, animals or pets. And...
Microphones.
Yeah, microphone-based games.
Except we're still looking for something
yeah,
else.
There's,
we have Lifeline, but we need a...
I was trying to see if I could find the other game by the Seaman guy, which is an RTS and pinball game with voice commands.
But it's for the GameCube and requires a GameCube microphone, so...
So Echo Jr. Is Echo Jr. good? I can't remember. I've played it a little bit. SingStar. Cats 2 on GBA. We unfortunately don't have a setup yet for doing game. I guess we could do emulated. Microphone, good excuse for
Takeshi's
challenge.
Nope.
Definitely going to try to track down the RTS pinball game by the guy who made Seaman, just because that has got to be an interesting game. There's no way you combine all those things and don't come up with something that isn't at least interesting.
Yeah. Anyway, we'll figure it out.
What kind of games do you want to stream? I will say, if we can come up with enough pet ones, that would be on point, because I'm very close to launching the Kickstarter for Russian Subway Dogs, my next game. So it would be thematic if we were to find some more pet ones. Bark Like a Dog? Woof.
That's Lifeline.
I have my own opinions about Odama. I'm not saying Odama is going to be good. I'm just going to say it's going to be interesting. So yeah, if you have any ideas, tweet at us. Oh my god, wait a second.
Yes, that's the person who freaked out about Beyblade Pixels last week.
Yeah, I'm just being trolled now. I'm pretty sure I'm just being trolled. Is Nintendogs interesting to watch? It might be. It's hard to stream because it's on the DS.
We'd
basically need to get a DS messed around with to...
We can't.
That'd be a long-term plan, getting one of those set
difficult.
Up.
Anyway, we've got some thoughts. We're gonna look into it.
Okay, I do not know whether to believe Havoc HQ. Turns out I like your games. So, Havoc HQ... Yeah. I'm gonna switch to typing quickly. If it'll let me. I love that slight pause on the Bluetooth
pause.
Keyboard. HQ. If you played the original Jam game. You know what? It's faster for me to just speak and wait for the... just curious with Havoc HQ. Don't know any of your games either. No worries. Oh, it went... Okay, it doesn't matter.
It's
cool. Just there.
It's
So yeah, the games I have made are Night of the Cephalopods, Cephalopods Co-op Cottage Defense, The Night Balloonists, Russian Subway Dogs, which was originally a Jam game, but I'm about to launch a Kickstarter for a much bigger, better, flashier version of it, and They Bleed Pixels. A bunch of those are free, and you can find them at www.spookysquid.com.
They're good, IMO.
I like them. You have to touch your boyfriend's emulated stylus input with the mouse input.
Okay, so we're doing none of those things. Great, awesome.
But yeah, if you have any ideas, tweet at us during the week. And yeah, if everything goes according to plan, I'll probably, during the stream, also show the trailer for Russian Subway Dogs, which hasn't been shown publicly yet. So I'll give everyone a little bit of a treat. So yeah, we'll be streaming Something and Seaman, hopefully not a dead Seaman, next week. See you all then.
See ya.